Hello my dear friends, welcome to my channel Fundamentals of Engineering. Click on subscribe button to explore engineering knowledge. In this lecture series of theory of metal cutting, we are going to discuss part 11, that is tool failure. So what are the parameters by using that we can say that the tool is failure whenever we are doing the machining, that we are going to see. So if you miss the earlier part of this lecture series, theory of metal cutting, link available in description box. You can check the link and watch whatever the parts you have missed, and also share the GATE aspirants, those who are studying for the GATE or ESC. There also you can send this link for theory of metal cutting. Now we'll start the tool failure criteria. The parameters which are used for measurement of satisfactoriness of machining is, means how we can say that tool failure is occurred. So there are some parameters that we have to see. Based on that we can say that tool is failed. So among that, first parameter is surface finish produced on workpiece. Surface finish produced on workpiece. You can see this diagram. So at the beginning of machining, it is found that excellence and mirror-like surface finish is produced. So at the beginning, we are getting the excellence or mirror-like surface finish, which can be produced by using this cutting tool on the workpiece. And when we are doing continuous operation by using that same cutting tool on the workpiece, after some times, when the lines are produced on the machine surface, some lines we are getting engraved lines on the machine surface, it is assumed that the surface finish is reduced and tool is failed. So if we are getting the lines on machine surface, then we can say that the surface finish on this machine part is disturbed, that will give tool failure. So this is the first parameter. Whenever at the start, whenever we are starting the machining, we are getting the mirror like finish or excellent finish on the workpiece. After successive use of the same cutting tool, we are getting lines on the machine surface where the surface finish is disturbed, and we can say that the tool is failed. So we can again use failed tool to do the sharp edges by using the grinding process, and we can do the machining operation. Second parameter, which is the forces induces during machining. So the forces which are generated in the machining operation, that can be checked by using this tool dynamometer. So this is our tool dynamometer. By using that tool dynamometer, we are checking the forces which are generated. So this is the milling tool dynamometer. The images are taken from the internet. So by connecting the dynamometer to the work table, and the forces in machining will be measured online. So whatever the forces which are induced in the machining, they are measured in an online mode, means while doing the machining operation. And whenever there is an increase in forces taking place more than 50%, so these forces are increases more than 15% of actual value. Then we can say that the tool has been failed. We can say that the tool has been failed. The tool failure occurred. So first parameter is the surface finish produced on the workpiece. Second parameter is the forces induced during machining. These we are measuring online, and if the forces are 15%, then the original forces or actual value of forces, then we can say that the tool is failed. The tool is failed. Then third parameter, by checking the power consumption. Checking the power consumption in the machining operation, that is in online mode. So by connecting ammeter, so this is the ammeter. When we connect ammeter to the input of the electrical motor, the current drawn by the motor will be measured online. So in power consumption, if you connect the ammeter to the motor, so we are measuring the current in a online mode while doing the machining operation. And whenever the current increases by the motor is greater than the 15%, if that current value is greater than the 15% than original value, if the current value is greater than 15% than the original value, then assuming that the tool failure occurred or tool is failed. So third part is what? Power consumption, where we are connecting ammeter to the electric motor. There we are measuring the current in online mode. If that current value is greater than the 15% than the original value, then the tool failure occurred and the tool is failed, and we can change the tool for the remaining operation. Fourth operation or fourth parameter is temperature of chip. So this temperature of chip can be measured online by using different setup, that is calorimetric setup, pyrometer or thermocouple. But here we can measure the temperature of chip observing the color of chip. So during the normal operation, we are getting color of the chip is a light blue color or metallic color. In normal machining, when there is a no failure, that the sharp edge tool we are using, at the normal machining we are getting blue or metallic color. So you can see here blue and metallic color we are getting, this one and this one. And when the machining is done with the failure tool, when we are getting the failure tool, because of the higher heat generation, the color of chip is turned to black or burnt color. In normal machining we are getting blue or metallic color, and when we are getting the failure tool, and that point the heat generation will be taking place, and due to that maximum heat generation we are getting the color of the chip as a black or burnt type. So we can say that color of chip is observed to be black or burnt type, there we can say that the failure of tool is occurred. Tool failure is occurred at that point. And also during the machining of high carbon workpieces, at a failure tool we are getting white colored gases. That the carbon is combined with the oxygen, natural oxygen, that is atmospheric oxygen, and that will create a carbon monoxide gases which are white in color. So whenever we are machining high carbon workpiece with a failure tool, with this failure tool, then we are getting the white color gases, then we can say that the tool is failed. The tool is failed. Now, this tool failure we are getting in a different mode. First mode is failure through plastic deformation. Failure through plastic deformation of a tool. So this is the first mode of tool failure. Second is failure through mechanical breakage. Due to the mechanical breakage of a whatever the conditions which are having in the workpiece, due to that sudden failure of a tool is taking place. That failure of tool, we can say that failure which we are getting due to the mechanical breakage. And third mode of failure is failure through mechanical gradual wear. Mechanical gradual wear. So by using these three modes of failure, we are getting the tool is failed. And these three modes of failure that can be observed by using these four parameters, like surface finish produced on the workpiece, forces induced during machining, power consumption and temperature of chip. In the next part, we are going to discuss how the modes of tool failure is taking place, and in a gradual wear, what are the different types we are getting, that we are going to see. So if you like this video, click like button and share the video. Always stay connected and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.